the end of the day, Melik, what you're seeing here is, again, a childish man who doesn't know how to govern, who doesn't know how to communicate, and all he wants to do is attack as opposed to lead. And so we could literally go all across America. I mean, we can go to his own. This is a guy who actually called the cops to arrest homeless folks who were actually on the streets outside of his building. And so he didn't want them on Fifth Avenue. I mean, this is what you're dealing with, a callous individual who doesn't know how to lead. And all he knows how to do is trash people. And where in the hell is the first lady with her anti-bullying campaign? When is she going to walk across the hall, because they don't sleep in the same bed? When is she going to walk across the hall and say, hey, grown-ass man, act like one?
Well, I don't think that we need to involve the first lady in this. I don't think that we need to make any sort of observations or comments.
Wait a minute. Does she not have an anti-bullying campaign?
I don't think that we need to make any comments on what goes on in their bedroom, just like that we shouldn't comment on what goes on in anyone's bedroom. But to your point about Donald Trump.
Does she not have an anti-bullying campaign?
Whether that or not, you don't have to throw the first lady.
Does she have an anti-bullying campaign?
You don't have to throw the first lady actually into this. The first lady's anti-bullying campaign should actually apply.
Why not?
I think across the board that politicians, celebrities, leaders in the community need to elevate their own language in addition to Donald Trump. They need to learn to elevate their own language. This just doesn't start or end with Donald Trump. Whether it's other politicians, whether it's people in the media, whether it's celebrities.
I need names. Melik, I don't play this game.
Maxine Waters,
all
Kamala Harris, Cory Booker. Maxine Waters, Kamala Harris, Cory Booker, representative.
That is even the
language,
degrading
the language that they use. The language that they use is part of what we're talking about when we talk about this toxic culture that we have here. So to say that they don't contribute to it is ridiculous. I mean, and this notion that somehow, well, we can't talk about Baltimore, but we can talk about places like, for instance, Mississippi. I mean, we're often talking about places that Republicans have, where that's the conversation going on now. What's happening in red states?
About?
I don't think that we need
to
have those.
Mississippi?
Well, I know. I gave that as an example of the conversations that the national conversations that we have about places that are particularly red states. So we generally have these type of conversations. Yes, Donald Trump should actually be mindful of how his comments are actually coming across to people in these areas. But the notion that people aren't going around talking about other cities, that's just false. It's just not true at all.
You know,
Jason, that's a little BS dance.
It's not a BS dance. You just don't like to hear it because that means
holding your. No, it is a BS dance.
That means that you're. That means that you're spreading it around.
It's a BS dance.
You're going to focus on Republicans because it benefits your
politics.
I get it.
It's a BS dance, Melik. It's a BS dance when a guy you voted for.
Yeah, and I'm going to vote for again in 2020.
Anytime he wants to talk about infestation. No, allow me. The guy you voted for and the guy you're going to vote for again.
Absolutely.
Whenever he discusses infestation, whenever he discusses rats and rodents, it's always black and brown people, Jason.
Not San Francisco.
Always black and brown people. Jason, go ahead.
That's very true.
Jason, go ahead.
But one thing I will say is that I'm not going to cape for some of the politicians in Baltimore who've been there for years, who have made some serious errors and mistakes. So I don't want to sit here and make it sound like I'm on their side. There have been mistakes making. I wouldn't put Elijah Cummings necessarily in that category, but there are some politicians in Baltimore. I don't think they're lining in their pockets with billions of dollars. I don't think that's happening. I think that they've tried to find solutions.
Also dealing with facts, Jason.
Yeah. No, I agree.
Let's deal in facts. This man stood there.
And,
Jason.
Yes.
Jason, this man stood there and said Elijah Cummings, he runs the city.
Yeah, that's completely false. That's absolutely false. And I think it didn't start with Elijah Cummings in 1996. It's institutional racism.
Let's expose the other lies.
Deindustrialization. It's war on drugs. I'm sorry. Go ahead. What were you saying?
Let's expose the other lies. Okay. He acts as if Johns Hopkins is not there. He acts as if the Under Armour CEO, who is from Baltimore, who's from Maryland, headquarters are in Baltimore, who met with Trump. So if Baltimore is so bad, see, this is what they do. The same thing happened when Freddie Gray took place. They're like, oh my God, Baltimore is on fire. No, Baltimore wasn't on fire. There were three blocks that were on fire, but Baltimore wasn't on fire. But this is the game they play, Jason and Kelly, where they wanted all of a sudden to say, oh, my God, it's all bad. It's all woeful. It's all trash. It's all corrupt. When Trump hails from a state where the governor had to resign because he was with prostitutes. Come on, man.
Again, the hypocrisy has always been there. I can't disagree with you. It's the truth. You know, specifically with Freddie Gray, I was there. Like, I was one of those few blocks that could see the smoke going up. Like, my Rite Aid, the one that I frequent, was the one that burned down. So I understand the Baltimore uprising. We call it the uprising because of what it stood for. So I get it. But what I don't understand is the hyperbole, the hypocrisy, the lying. It's just not necessary. But this president isn't necessary, so we have to deal with that, too.
And what is shameful to have individuals who excuse all of this, who say, oh, yeah, I'm going to vote for him, who clearly don't mind him being despicable, who don't mind his shameful behavior, who don't mind his racist attacks.
And none of what you're saying is going to change anyone's opinion about voting for him, Roland. None of those insults are going to change anyone's opinion about whether or not they're going to support Donald Trump. So you can call him
despicable.
You can call him anything that you want to call him, and it's not going to change anyone's opinion. Who's going to vote for him just as the same, it's not
going to
go in the other direction. So you can call him despicable from today all the way up to the end of the week. It's not going to change anyone's position on whether or not they're going to vote for him.
But that's the tragedy of it all.
Roland doesn't dictate votes. Roland is one person.
Allow me to finish. Excuse me. What does it say about the individual who doesn't have a problem with lying, who doesn't have a problem with him being degrading, who doesn't have a problem with his shameful tweets, who doesn't have a problem with how he attacks
It means
people,
that they can make decisions for themselves without Roland dictating on it means that they can make decisions for themselves without Roland giving them the go-ahead to do so. So that's why we can.
You,
it means
it
that
means
Roland has an opinion about it, and it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what your opinion is about me, Donald Trump, or anyone who supports him, because it doesn't matter. This is your position. This is going to be your position.
Oh, no, it does matter.
It actually doesn't matter.
November
of 2020,
but you're making excuses for shameful behavior.
What if we come with facts?
Right.
What if we come with facts about Donald Trump and his corruption and his racism?
But what corruption?
Would you be willing to change your vote?
But what corruption?
If we were able to come with facts.
But you have to show it to me first.
I can show you.
He said some bad things about Baltimore is not going to be enough.
No. I can show you the Mueller report.
I can show you obstruction of justice.
But that's not. I'm talking about your vote. Is there anything that would alter your vote?
And as we've had this conversation before, at this point, no. Who knows what may happen tomorrow, next month, or anything? But because Jason doesn't like him, because Jason thinks that he's a
That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying if you are presented
because of the Mueller report, I'm saying if you are presented with new information.
But what new information? But you're like, no.
We get new information daily about how corrupt this president is.
The entire talking points that have been here forever, so you haven't produced anything new.
The fact
that somebody could literally sit here and with all the crap this dude has done, mm-hmm. with all of the despicable cabinet secretaries who have been corrupt and still say I'm going to vote for him, that's shameful.
All right, folks,
my unfiltered video in just one moment. All right, folks, you heard me talk a lot about marijuanastock.org. Why? Because I want to keep you informed of investment opportunities that make sense. We've all watched the growth of the cannabis industry. A recent report by New Frontier Data estimates the global cannabis market at more than $340 billion. We know that marijuana legalization is sweeping the country state by state. We also know that marijuana has a good cousin, the hemp plant, with a much higher concentration of CBD. That means hemp gives you all the medical benefits of marijuana without getting you high. Until recently, hemp farming was practically illegal in the U.S. and heavily regulated by the DEA. However, the 2018 Farm Bill changed all of that, making it legal to grow hemp CBD in the U.S., thus creating one of the largest commodities worldwide. They need land to grow all of the plants. And folks, this is where our friends at 420 Real Estate come in. Their business model is simple. They buy land that supports hemp CBD grow operations and lease it to licensed, high-paying tenants. That's right, they are hemp CBD landlords. And you can get in on the action. Our friends at 420 Real Estate decided to do something special for the Roland Martin Unfiltered family. Originally, the minimum investment level was $500. But right now, you can invest in this crowdfunding campaign for as little as $200. That's right, $200 up to $10,000. Let me recap. This is a $340 billion industry that is still growing, and you can participate with as little as $200. To invest, go to marijuanastock.org. That's marijuanastock.org. Get in the game, and get in the game now. Now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video. You want to support Roland Martin Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. By going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com, you can make this possible